So you might know what a major and a minor scale is, but there's actually tons of different scales out there. And the major and minor scale are actually just two of a selection of seven scales. And these seven scales are called modes. Now, these modes are something that are used, or at least a few of them are, in a lot of soundtracks in films and video games. So it's worth at least identifying what they are and how you can use them in your own compositions. So in this video, we'll describe, first of all, what are modes and where did they come from. Then we'll show you some examples of how they're used in films, and then how you can implement modes for your own compositions. So where do the modes actually come from? Well, they stem from the major scale. First of all, let's recap what a major scale is. If we look at the simplest major scale, the C major scale, it's made up of the following distances between notes. It has a whole tone, whole tone, half tone, whole tone, whole tone, whole tone, half tone. When I say a whole tone, I mean two semitones combined. So this is a half tone, and from here to here is a whole tone, from here to here is a half tone. From here to here is a half tone. So the C major scale has whole tones, half tones. Now, if I were to change the distance between any of these notes, we no longer have a C major scale. If I were to do, instead of whole tone going to another whole tone, I went up only a half, this is no longer a C major scale. And you can actually hear that, but the key thing is that we have created a new scale by changing these distances between the notes. So, what happens if we were to have all the notes in a C major scale, but I were somehow to change the distances between them without changing the notes? Let me show you what I mean. If I were to start, instead of on the first note in C major, if I started on the second note, and I went using all the notes in the C major scale, but I've started on the second one, now the distances between notes are no longer the exact same order as what they were previously. Now it's, instead of a whole tone, half tone, now it's a whole tone. So it's subtle, but we've actually changed the scale because we've changed the distances between the notes. We've changed the order of whole tones and half tones. And by doing that, we have something new. So when you start on a different tonic note, that's the name we give for the first note, if we start on the second in the major scale, instead of the first, we started on the second, and we have a new scale, we can do this exactly seven times before we end up back at C again. So we can create seven different scales just by using the same notes in the major scale by starting on a different first tonic note. So I know this will take a little time to wrap your mind around, but it'll get easier once I show you the quick shortcut later on in this video. So for now, realize that this is the C major scale, and we have a name for each of these scales that we can create by starting on different tonic notes. So if we start on the first note in the major scale, we call this a mode, the first mode, and the name we've given this is Ionian. So whenever you hear Ionian, it's identical to major. You can think of them as the same. If we start on the second tonic note of a major scale, we have the name Dorian. If we start on the third, we call this the Phrygian. We start on the fourth, we call this the Lydian. If we start on the fifth, we call this the Mixolydian. This is the Aeolian, and this is actually the same as the natural minor scale. So whenever you hear the term natural minor, this is the relative minor to a major scale. It uses all the same notes as a C major scale, except it's minor. So it uses all the same notes, but it's the minor. And the last one is called the Locrian. So the interesting part is that although we use the same notes as in major scale, they sound different. This sounds significantly different than that. One's major, one's minor, but they're using the same notes in the scale, and yet they have such a different flavor, such a different emotion that we get out of them. And even though they're the same notes, we can come up with different chord progressions by saying, this is going to be our first chord, or this is going to be our first chord. And by changing what we determine to be our chords in a progression, we come up with different melodies, even though we're using the same notes in the scale. So what we've done in a lot of soundtracks is we've discovered that by adjusting the scale from one mode to another mode, we can get a completely different emotion. Well, let's think about how these are actually used in soundtracks. First of all, let's think about the sound. An Ionian mode is essentially just a major mode. It's just the major scale. The Dorian is essentially a minor scale with a raised sixth. The Phrygian is quite different. The Lydian is essentially just the major scale with a raised fourth, so it sounds mostly major, but with a raised fourth. The Mixolydian is a major, but with a lowered seventh. The Aeolian is minor, so that's going to be a sadder, darker sounding scale. And then the Locrian is a little bit of a wild hat. It's all over the place. So how are these actually used in films? Well, Ionian is used obviously for happy tunes. These are happy sounds. The Dorian is more of a jazzy sound. The Phrygian is tends to be used for dark, emotional songs. The Lydian tends to be a jazzy, worldly, triumphant sound. Mixolydian is great for triumphant sounds with brass and strings. Aeolian is the minor scale, so this is usually something beautiful, something darker, sadder. And then no one really uses the Locrian very often because it's a little bit odd sounding. So now I have a few examples for you of where these scales are actually used in films. And this is a example way to wrap your head around how might I be using these modes.
If I could save time in a bottle, the first thing that I'd like to do is to save every day till eternity passes away, just to spend them with you.
Thank you.
One great website that's useful in case you ever forget what the modes are or what notes they are and you have a keyboard nearby is to think of the pianoscales.org. And this is a great website because it just breaks it down extremely simply. It shows you that there's 7 modes, and if you were to click into one of the modes, it'll show you the exact notes that you have on the keyboard starting on each individual note. So if you were to start with a tonic note, your first note being C, these are the notes that you'll be using. If you start with the note D, these are the notes that you will be using. So pianoscales.org is really helpful. Check that out. Now, if you're using FL Studio, your work's even easier for you because they built in these scales for you. If you go into a piano roll, you'll see a little button here that's called the stamp tool. You can select that and you can see the different scales already built in for you. They have the Dorian, they have the Aeolian, they have major, Lydian, Phrygian, Mixolydian, and you can select one of these. Choose a note to be your tonic note, your first note, and you can see all the notes that are going to be within that scale. And then you know that any note that you choose as long as it's a note that's within that scale, it will sound based on these qualities that we gave you earlier. So you'll know that anything Aeolian, it's going to sound beautiful dark as long as you stay within the notes of that scale. So this is how you use modes, this is where they came from, and how you can use them.